evening everyone, this is Rupali and you are watching Odisha. A media workshop on air pollution and climate change reporting was organized by Switch On Foundation in collaboration with Socrates and the Energy Policy Institute at the University of Chicago, EPIC India as knowledge partner. Around 50 journalists from Bhubaneswar, Cuttack and Puri joined the workshop to gain valuable insights, facilitate meaningful discussions and learn innovative approaches to climate change reporting. Managing Director of Switch On Foundation, Vinay Jaju said, Odisha is amongst the most vulnerable state facing the climate crisis. There is a need to highlight the urgency and need for action against air pollution and climate change among masses. Media has a central role in adding impetus to this. Change is only possible through collaboration, engagement and communication. The Government of India's National Clean Air Program is a step towards resolving the problem of deteriorating ambient air quality. The NCAP has set a time-bound goal to improve air quality across the country, focusing on 132 non-attainment cities where air pollution standards are not being met. This includes 7 cities of Odisha: Bhubaneswar, Cuttack, Baleshwar, Rourkela, Anugul, Talcher and Kalinganagar. With the base year as 2017, the program is set to achieve reduction of 20% to 30% of particulate matter by 2024. Senior journalist BBC World Sandeep Sau commented, "I compliment Switch On Foundation for organizing this workshop for media persons on this very important issue. Air pollution and climate change pose a serious threat to the ecosystem. I believe there is a lot the media can do to raise awareness about the threat and the ways to fight it by presenting facts, figures and insights around the issue." He suggested that we can consider having a daily air pollution chapter or bulletin in media.
So there is no doubting the fact that Odisha is one of the most vulnerable state and is facing the brunt of climate change. And हम ये भी जानते हैं कि climate change, air pollution impacts the most vulnerable. और vulnerable के हम जानते हैं आर हमारे किसान भाई हैं, बच्चे जो workers हैं, मजदूर हैं, farmers हैं, जिनके तो they are and we also know कि we have a lot of vulnerable communities in Odisha. So दोनों तरह से Odisha is very much at the NSE कारण से embarked on a cycle ride, उसमें कुछ आप लोगों से मिला मुलाकात हुई थी मेरी, मैंने cycled across Odisha, बहुत farmers, youth के साथ engagement हुआ था उस समय इसी चीज़ को लेकर के. Now, if you can go on, so there are three largely areas in Odisha that we are highlighting. एक तो हो गया of course on agriculture, खरीफ crop we know is really really affected because of climate change, where we know that yield decrease होती है in the खरीफ season. दूसरा हो गया livelihoods के बारे में already मैंने बता दिया. Next which is मैं कुछ आंकड़े पढ़ना चाहूँगा यहाँ पर weather and coastal erosion. उड़ीसा में जो देखते हैं 8 coastal districts में what has already happened is six coastal districts में 2489 hectares of land in these districts have already faced erosion.
Regional Director of Communications at EPIC India, Asirvat Raha said, "Improving air quality needs robust policy action. Media has to be an enabler by constantly ensuring that research and evidence-driven discussion around air pollution continue to grab headlines. For this change to happen, media, citizen groups and policymakers all have to take equal onus and action."
But we are moving in that direction, and if we don't act now, we will reach there faster than we would have done otherwise. So now I think is the time when we should pull up our shocks and start acting, so that we don't come to the stage where we can't breathe like the people of Delhi do in the winter months. Well, breathing becomes difficult. To ensure that we don't reach that stage, we need to act now.
Senior Consultant and HOD Pediatrics and Neonatology Care Super Speciality Hospital, Bhubaneswar, Dr. Mamata Panda said, air pollution is associated with a broad spectrum of acute and chronic illness, such as asthma, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, COPD, cardiovascular disease and cancer. The ever-increasing trend of AQI level poses a major threat to the vulnerable communities like the children and old aged people. Children are more vulnerable towards the adverse effect of the air pollution. Chief of the Bureau, Pramay Devendra Saur, stated, "We applied SwiChan's aim to sensitize the media on climate change issues. There is nobody better than the media who can spread awareness about the issue to the layman who is actually getting affected out there. Media can play a crucial role in reporting climate change."